Hey everyone, this is TheSighBored here. Today we are looking at the Innovv C3 action camera. I'll begin by saying all the stuff that I like about this camera, and after that I'll be telling you all the stuff that I am not so pleased with this kind of camera. So starting off with what I like, what I like about this camera is that the recording unit is small and light. It's made of metal, so it's a bit sturdy. It won't break that easily if you accidentally dropped it. The other thing I like is also the camera lens. It's separate and it's also light. The lens itself is light and small, so it's easy to mount on different surfaces. It comes with the this cradle kind of mount that works with this lens. It is plastic, but it actually holds the lens pretty solidly. So in terms of worrying that the camera lens might fall out, I don't think that is a big concern. It really holds it very strongly. I needed to take a lot of energy to actually get it out from the mount. Just to show you quickly, very simple. Yes. As you can see, it's damn tight fit. The fit is so damn tight. And this indent here, I'm not sure if you can see it, is the orientation of the lens. So this needs to be pointing upwards. Alright. To use this camera, you definitely want to turn off, for motorcycle use, kindly turn off your G sensor and motion sensor. Alright. To turn it off, you need to update the settings through the user GUI interface software that you can get from the website. The next thing about the mount which I like is, apart from what we have talked about, it comes with an external mic, so it will be useful for vlogging or if you want to record audio from a different source from where the camera lens is mounted on. Right? The camera unit has its own internal mic, and to install the external mic, you're using the same port where you charge the camera with, which is this USB port. It's the same port where you're going to connect your microphone into, right? Just like that. And the HDMI port is for the camera lens. The camera comes with a few mounts, not that many mounts, but not to worry, because the mounts are using the tripod style connector adapter, which you can actually adapt it to the GoPro or RAM mounts. I'll show you that in a bit. That's basically a quick look at the Innovv C3 and the main features that I like about it. Now, moving on to the features that I find might be an issue for motorcycle use for this camera will be that because of the separated camera lens and the housing unit, you will need to figure out how to store the extra cable, this length of cable. If you are using it, let's say, on your helmet, where you're going to route this cable, and also where you're supposed to attach this recording unit. You can always attach it on the front pocket of your jacket or your belt, stuff like that, but you need to make sure that the weather doesn't change suddenly, the ease of access to turn it on and off. Okay, so with that being said, I feel that this camera is more suitable for some sort of fixed setup where you install the camera nicely with the cables routed properly and you just leave it as it is and just turn it on and off when you please. If you're using it for something temporary where you want to set up a shot maybe on the dash for a while and then move it to somewhere else on the bike, it's going to be a bit tricky because you need to take some time to set the camera up. So that is the big difference between this camera with all the cables, right, and the other type of camera like the GoPro where everything is in one housing unit with the waterproof housing and mount, so you don't have all these cables running around. So it's the difference of the camera is also the part where it might be a problem if you are going to have various setup on this camera. The other thing is that the camera lens itself does not have a protective housing in front of it. So if you mount it too close to the ground or too close to where dirt or sand might get kicked up, you are probably going to have high chances of having something hit the camera lens, and that is not going to be good. If you break it, I don't know, you probably need to order a replacement unit and so on. That should be all I have for you right now regarding my personal opinions about this camera. I'll show you a few demo setups that we can use for this camera on the bike, and maybe you guys have better ideas or some suggestions on that. Okay, let's go on to the next part of this. Alright guys, so right now what we have is a helmet setup for the Innovv C3. This is not the mounts that came with the camera. Obviously this is GoPro adapted. You can see here, this part is where the adapter is coming from. And this is the mount from Innovv C3. It looks a bit bulky if you do some angle shots around. Maybe a 180 to show how much is sticking out beside the helmet. Okay, now right up, what I have here in my hand is the mount that came with the C3. As you can see, it's way simpler, and if I were to stick it on the helmet, there's a comparison. Hope you can see the big difference between how much is sticking out on the GoPro mount compared to this. The reason I'm not sticking this onto the helmet is because I already have this here for the GoPro, so I'll just be using this instead. Now, the main thing you can see is this piece of cable that's running from the back of the lens. So, the lens itself is light. The helmet, in fact, if I were to attach a GoPro right here, you'll definitely feel the weight. You'll feel the helmet starting to tip down on this direction. It will be a bit troublesome to ride, especially at high speeds or stuff like that when you're riding, because of the wind drag and the weight. This is much lighter, definitely, but it has this cable running at the back. So the cable runs, it's actually quite long. Let me just show you how long the cable. I can actually loop it around the helmet to show you how it attaches to the recording unit. So it's a quite long of a cable that you need to be able to find a way to actually keep it hidden or keep it tucked away as a helmet setup. This will be the normal setup for helmet cams, I guess, but you can always do different ways. You can even mount it on the top of your helmet, on top here. Maybe this position is nice where my finger is. Let me just take the mount again, for example, right, top down, or maybe a further bit back. You can even mount it on the front where I'm pointing at right now. If you have the GoPro, another setup, you can mount it straight facing right in front of you. You'll be right in your line of sight. So these are the few examples that you can have on the helmet mount setup. The test footage or the angle views that you get, I'll be sharing it on a different video. This is just to show you the possibilities of what you can do. And also take note, this is the indentation that marks where the top part of the camera is, the upright. Okay, I haven't tightened this stuff up, but the mount itself, the camera itself to the cradle, is really strong. I wouldn't worry about it, but if you are worried, I'm pretty sure you can figure out maybe just a rubber band or a cable tie to hold this camera from coming out of this cradle. Okay guys, so right now, now what we're looking at is a possible setup on the bike. This setup is not using the mounts that came with the camera, because like I said, there's not many mounts that come to the camera, and I'm just showing you different options that you can use. What I have here is the ram mount, the ram arm, and the ram ball joint mount that is having the tripod. Okay, if you can see, you should be able to see clearly. This top part is the Innovv C3 mount. This is the only thing that I'm using that comes from the camera in the box. As you can see now, if you follow me to where the cables are, you can see that it's quite messy with the cable that I have to loop just for a demo. So you have this much of cable that you need to find a way or think of how you want to store it. Okay, so it's there's so many possibilities of how you want to hide the cable. Maybe something simple like, you know, just putting it like this and tying it down. Okay, but you need to make sure that if you're recording the sound from here, you need to make sure that this doesn't vibrate, or else you'll be getting a lot of vibration sound. If you have the recording unit outside like this, for example, then you'll be getting a lot of wind noise. Okay, so you need to think about that as well. The other option would be if you have the external mic, like what I have here, that comes with the camera. Alright, if you have it like this way and somehow you manage to route it to your helmet, then you can have a vlog, but the source is coming from your bike, but you can still be talking through this external mic. Or maybe you want to get your exhaust sound, then you can route this. You can see it's quite long too, so you can route this cable to maybe somewhere nearby to exhaust. It's all about the, this is more to managing your wiring, the wires, the cables. It's more to that than about mounting the camera. I'm going to show you maybe one or two more possible setups, maybe a rear facing shot or a dash cam kind of possible setup. So we'll be back in a bit. Alright guys, now this is a different setup I have here. We are still using the RAM mount. As you can see, it's the same one I took from the earlier shot, the arm and the ball joint with the tripod. Still using the C3 cradle for the camera lens. And as you can see, it's quite sleek and covert, a very low profile view. Nobody can really see that there's a camera unless you see this big ass cable running again. So we have this long cable here, as you can see the loops, and back to the housing unit. For a temporary shot, again, you need to be a bit creative on how you want to tidy up the cables. Maybe you can just cable tie could be your best friend to maybe probably tie it like this. And yeah, the housing unit, you know, you can either, for me it's easy because I have all these ready mounts, but for you guys, you might probably need to do some sort of planning ahead. Okay, the nice part about this is also going to be a bit of the con side, is that if you have a look at the indentation here, it's hardly noticeable. Maybe a different dot, a spot of paint, like a red color or white color paint on top of this indentation, will make it easier for you to see the angle. And also, for a rear facing shot on a motorcycle, what you need to understand, if it's raining or a wet road, there'll be a lot of water and dirt that gets kicked up, and it might actually dirty the lens or even scratch the lens. So if you're going to make this a permanent setup, you want to make sure that it's not in the direct path of the water spray from the tire. Alright guys, what I have here is the number plate bracket. Normally for normal usage, this slot here is actually meant for signal light. But since I have an integrated tail light, I don't need separate signal lights. So you can actually attach the camera for a rear facing dash cam style. And the cable probably can run under the belly, this under tray. And the housing unit can be inside the seat, the rear seat compartment area. I can actually mount it for you as a demo, but you can get the idea. It's not going to be hard to mount something over here. It's very covert. People won't know that the camera is installed. And okay, let's go on to the next. Right now we are in front of the bike. I'm just going to show you a quick look on how you might possibly want to set up a dash cam style for the front of your bike using this mount. That is the Innovv C3 mount that came in the box. The neck itself is adjustable. You can rotate it. Okay. For my case, on my bike, the bottom part here right at the center is actually curved in upwards. So to mount it like this way is not going to be good unless you like looking at the road. Possibly for my case, maybe if I wanted to, I could mount it like this and rotate it like this. As long as you have the camera house, the camera itself pointed leveled in the cradle but leveled straight, it doesn't matter if the mount is slanted. If you have a look at from this side, from the front, you can see that the mount itself, the cradle is angled, but if you can put the camera aligned straight, it still doesn't matter. but it's going to be a bit visible, for in my case a bit more visible. Right, the other way to that I could think of mounting the front facing dash cam style for the Innovv C3 would be here where my this adapter is, right underneath the ram air opening. But I'll still need to figure out how to run the awesome cable, this stick cable here, how I'm going to run it from this portion up, probably up the windscreen to the meter area where the recording unit's probably going to sit at. So like I said, the design of the camera, the separate lens is cool because it's smaller, it's lighter, right, more aerodynamic, but the cable that comes with it is going to be the other point that you might consider of how you're going to, let me just roll it again for you to see how long this cable is going to be. Right, so this is the part where you need to think about how you want to route your cable for this camera. So guys, in summary, what we have seen is the camera itself, the housing, the recording unit, the camera lens, a couple of the mounts that came with the Innovv C3 box, a few mounts that didn't come with it, which we can actually adapt it, like this suction cup and this GoPro style adapter for tripod, and even the RAM mount. So all these are the possible mounts that you can use together with your Innovv C3 to mount up your camera. Now, as a summary, for the technical aspect of the camera, the operations, the buttons, it's all in the manual, and I believe a more technical review has been done by Techmoan. I'll share the link out for that technical review of the camera. For myself, I'm mainly concerned in the application of this camera in terms of riding usage, what kind of angles we can use, what kind of setups we can use, and even how it performs as a motor vlog equipment. That will be in the next video I'll do. It's for all about the test footages that I'll make, daytime, nighttime footages, and so on. With that being said, I guess this will be the wrap up of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed checking out the Innovv C3, and I hope to get the next video out to you guys the soonest possible. With that, ride safe, safe ride.